Notion just released an entirely new way to turn Notion pages into full websites. We're gonna get into how it works, new settings, what's on the Notion free plan versus the plus plan, and how to add your own domain. And lastly, we'll get into some use cases to get a better sense of if this is for you, if it makes sense to publish your website on Notion. Let's jump in. If we haven't met, I'm Dave DeCespedes. I'm a certified Notion consultant. I have a newsletter on all things Notion and productivity, and I've made several Notion-focused courses. I'll add a few links below if you want to connect. Before we get into it, it's worth asking, why would you host your website on Notion? There are tons of platforms out there. It's gotten ridiculously easy to design, build, and publish your website. But if you already house a lot of your content on Notion and you just need a simple site to get up and running without getting bogged down by all the design details, turning a Notion page into a website only takes a few clicks. Let's see how this works. Okay, so we have a Notion page here, and this was actually a landing page I used for a Notion consulting course. And a couple things I want to highlight here. Number one, the page icon. This is going to come into play as our favicon in a little bit. Here we've got an embedded video, a link call out. In this case, a linked view of a database. This is bringing in blog posts from a blog post database, and it's filtering to only show a select few. So we'll get into how to not only set up our page with a custom domain, but also link to other pages in the site. And then the rest of this is standard content that you might see on a landing page for a course, and also embedded databases. So we'll get into some of these details. First thing we're gonna do is click share. So this is gonna look very familiar. If you share pages or databases with team members, there's not really much change here. But if we go to publish, you'll notice this is entirely new. So when we hit publish, we're gonna get a new set of features, and we're gonna revisit the custom domain in a little bit. But first, if you've added a Notion domain to your workspace, that's gonna show up by default. You could also add additional domains here, and we'll get into the details of like what's on the free plan versus plus plan. So here we have our domains. If I wanna add a new domain, I would click in this new domain, and here we have the option to use a .notion.site versus adding our custom domain, which is a paid feature. So we're gonna keep it as a default. A couple things to note, you could turn on search engine indexing. This gives us a few additional options. Essentially, if you want this to show up in search results, if somebody's searching the name of your site or topics that you're talking about often on your page, then they'll show up in results. And then also customizing the description. This is also for Google and search engines to better understand what your site is about. So you can customize that here if we have that turned on. The next thing is link expiration. You probably are gonna have this off, but if you have an event or there's a deadline, you could set this to expire, which means that this page will no longer be visible after a certain date. So something to keep in mind there, even though we'll probably wanna keep it off by default. If we head to site customization, this is also entirely new. This is a little bare bones, but I'm assuming that Notion is gonna be adding additional features in the upcoming months. So first thing, if we're sharing a link to this page, the share preview will bring in the first image or whatever it sees on your page, but you can customize this. So if we upload an image, let's say we click upload image here, I wanna add a custom image, that's going to update here. So that way, anytime this link is shared, this is the image that's gonna show up along with that link. Next, which is pretty cool, you could set the default to light mode or dark mode or the user's system settings. So if somebody has settings where after the sun sets, it automatically goes to dark mode, that will apply there. So we'll, let's say, keep dark mode here. And then a couple other notes, changing the favicon, as I mentioned, this is taking the page icon by default, but you could also upload your own image here. So same process, should be a square by default, just to make sure the image looks the same, looks consistent, doesn't get cut off. Next thing is with the header. So this has been something that's been requested quite a bit, at least for people who have turned Notion pages into websites. First, if you've got breadcrumbs, this is, for example, if you've got a page that lives within another page, that lives within another page, you're gonna see all of those pages at the top of the screen. So if you wanna just kind of simplify this, you could turn off breadcrumbs. Next, if you are only putting together a landing page that doesn't have a lot of content and you don't need search, you can also turn that on or off. I'd say if you have blog content or multiple pages within a database, definitely helpful to have search, so we're gonna leave that on. And lastly, if it's not a template, you definitely wanna turn off duplicate as template just so that it's cleaner and more functional. The last one, which is the Notion watermark, this is only possible to turn off if you set up a custom domain, which we're going to do in a little bit. I'm going to close out of here. We're going to publish changes. So we're going to go back to our landing page, go to share. We're going to go to site customization. And within here, we're going to head to custom and we're going to add a few pages. So first, we're going to head to header and we're going to click add page. And from here, I want to add two pages. One is the about page and the second is the Notion Consulting blog. So if I publish these changes, just to kind of call back where those live, if we scroll down on the page, that blog page with all of the blog posts are here right under resources. And the about page is right under that about section here. We could potentially like add a footer where we're adding all of the pages or subpages as an option, but just to kind of see what that looks like in the header. So we have these here. Let's say we want to change the names of these just to kind of make it cleaner. I'm going to go back to change this to maybe just blog and that next section to about. I think building this out probably makes sense to add a footer where you've got several pages. I could see additional pages kind of happening here now that I'm building this out. So here you could see that it automatically updated. So we've got about, blog, and so on. So back in the header, if you want to add additional pages, they do need to be housed within the parent page. So something to keep in mind there. And then if we publish changes, we could see here, we've got our page, we've got our about page. And if I go back, and if I want to go to the blog, I can see those blog posts as well. So we have that set up, but let's say we want to remove this built with Notion watermark and we want to set up our custom domain. We're going to do that next. First thing we're going to do is go back to share and go to publish. And under our websites, we're going to go to manage all domains. So we have here two domains, but these are Notion sites, but we want to add our own. This is a part of the paid plus plan. So this is an additional to your plan. I believe it's $8 or $10 per month. I'll add the exact numbers in the description in case you're interested. But if we go to new domain, we're going to create or connect a custom domain. So we'll click continue here. From here, we're going to add www.notionconsultantcamp.com and then click continue. So depending on the tool that you're using, we're going to want to copy these into the right places within your site. So we're going to go ahead and do that now. If you're like me, you're going to get a pop-up similar to this. So you might have to check a few times before it finally connects. Once your domain is verified, you'll be able to go back into site customization and go ahead and turn off the Notion watermark, which will just kind of clean up the header a little bit more. And then we'll hit publish changes, and then that should be good to go. One thing to call out in terms of pricing, this could be a little bit confusing depending on what plan we're on. If we head into settings, if you're on the free plan, there's going to be some limitations here. So you might need to upgrade to the plus plan to get access to the website features. And then also in sites, I believe it's $10 per site. So any custom domain that you're connecting, we're paying for each of those individually. But keep in mind, you do get the Notion sites. So if you don't have a custom domain and you're okay with just using the Notion.site, then that's probably a good option. I'll drop the details into the description below just so that we have clarity on exactly what we're paying for this feature, because it is separate from the standard Notion workspace. So that brings us back to the big question of, should you use Notion to build and host your website? In my previous video that I did a while back talking about connecting Notion, Super, and MemberSpace to create a website where you can have a login and have more paywalled content, I mentioned this is a solid option if any of these apply to you. Number one, you already have content organized in Notion and just want to publish it. Two, you want to set up a landing page as quickly as possible. And again, you're already a Notion user. Or lastly, you're okay with the Notion aesthetic, or you even prefer the minimal vibe. And you're also okay with the limitations in how much you can customize with the page. I'm sure Notion is working on additional features that are going to be able to further customize these pages. But this is definitely a pretty solid start. And side note, if you want more control over the look and feel, there are tools like super.so that are still solid options, as there's a whole ecosystem of templates, there's CSS codes, there's resources, so that you could really take it to another level in terms of customization. Personally, I think this is going to be a pretty solid option for people who get overwhelmed with the idea of building and customizing their own website, or just don't have the time to build one from scratch. Curious to hear if you're thinking about using Notion to host your website, or if you've got any features in mind that will kind of tip the scales in terms of moving your site to Notion. Let me know in the comments. And as always, if you found this helpful, give this video a like. And if you're interested in more Notion productivity content, hit that subscribe button. See you in the next video. Cheers.